Namo dasa bhagavato arahato sama sambuddhasa. Namo dasa bhagavato arahato sama sambuddhasa. Namo dasa bhagavato arahato sama sambuddhasa. Today we would like to introduce you about Nibbana origination, Paticca Samuppada. I will relate again Anapana meditation, stage by stage. In Samatha Anapana meditation, there are four stages. Number one, long breath. Number two, short breath. Number three, the whole body of breath. Number four, subtle breath or cessation of breath. If you attain fourth jhana stage, your breath will stop, will cease completely without remainder. Cease completely. While you are digging, you are anabana pedi bhaga nimeda kaundabat sign as object. Based on this anabana fourth jhana, if you practice four elements meditation systematically, you will see ultimate materiality and ultimate mentality. This stage is mentioned after Anabana Bodhichana Buddha as Idi Ijadavagaye Kayanubasi Viharadi Vaidavagaye Kayanubasi Viharadi Ijadavagaye Kayanubasi Viharadi. A bhikkhu abides contemplating the body as body internally, and he abides contemplating the body as body externally, and he abides contemplating the body as body both internally and externally. If you want to practice dependent origination, before you are practicing dependent origination, you should try to understand ultimate materiality and ultimate mentality both internally and externally. If you can discern ultimate materiality and mentality both internally and externally, other than if you practice divided origination, you can understand easily. So if you want to understand ultimate materiality, how you should practice? You must practice four elements meditation systematically. When you are concentrating deep enough, you will see small particles called kalabas. If you analyze kalabas, then you will understand ultimate materiality. Then please continue to discern ultimate mentality. Then please discern ultimate materiality and mentality both internally and externally. In external world, while you are discerning ultimate mentality, you should discern as a general only, not one by one. You cannot read others' mind. But as a general, you should try to discern ultimate mentality as group only. So there are two types of body, kaya. Kaya they translate as body. What is body? Mental body and material body. What is mental body and material body? According to Buddha's teaching, materiality and mentality arise as group, not single. Materiality arise as small body gas called kalabas, as a group only. They cannot rise singly. So they are called kaya body. In the same way, mentality also arise as a group only. They cannot rise singly. So they are also called mental body. If you want to discern externally how you should trace, for example, please touch your rope. You can feel their hardness, roughness, heaviness, softness, smoothness, lightness, flowing, cohesion, heat and coldness, supporting and pushing. So if you get these four elements, then you can see, very soon you will see small body gas. If you analyze these small body gas, in each body gas there are eight types of materiality, such as earth element, water element, fire element, wind element, color, odor, flavor, nutritive essence. In each kalapa there is fire element. That fire element is called tejo. Tejo dhatu or udu, temperature. That temperature produces new kalapa. In that kalapa there is also tejo fire element. That fire element also produces another new kalapa. So many generations successfully for a long time, they will rise and pass away in this way. If you get this eight types of materiality in your clothes, in the same way you get this on the floor, four elements, you can see only just small body gas. You cannot see flow. If you analyze these small body gas, you can see only eight types of materiality. In the same way, in anime world, wherever you pay attention to four elements, you will see only just small body gas called kalapas. If you analyze these kalapas, in each kalapa there are eight types of materiality. Sometimes, including sound, there may be nine types of materiality only. In the same way, if you discern four elements in your eye, you can see only a group of body gas called kalapas. If you analyze these kalapas, you can see adimic materiality. In the same way, in external world, if you pay attention, four elements of external eye, you can see only a group of small body gas only. If you analyze these small body gas, you can see only adimic materiality. In the same way, as general, if you discern four elements in external animate world, you can see only a group of small body gas called kalapas. If you analyze these kalapas, you can see adimic materiality only. In the same way, you should discern adimic mentality like internally, like internal. When you are designing internally, adimic mentality, you design both object and base together. And then you can design object. When object appear in your mind and eye, etc., both those, other than you can design adimic mentality. In the same way, when you are designing external world, also you can design both object and door or base together, and then you gain this adimic mentality in the same way. If you gain this adimic mentality both internally and externally, other than only if you practice dependent origination, you will understand. Buddha explained this stage to discern dependent origination in Mahasri Prana Sutta like that. Samudhiya dhammanu bhasiwa gaya same viharadi. Oya dhammanu bhasiwa gaya same viharadi. Samudhiya oya dhammanu bhasiwa gaya same viharadi. Samudhiya dhammanu bhasi means he must contemplate the rising phenomena internally and externally both. Vaya Dhammanubhasi means he must contemplate perishing phenomena internally and externally both. Samudhiya Vaya Dhammanubhasi means he must contemplate arising and perishing phenomena or dissolution phenomena both internally and externally. How you should practice? because of the rising of causes. Adimedaladi rise. Because of the complete cessation of causes, adime materiality and mentality cease completely without remainder. Such type of contemplation is called causal rising and passing away. There is also another rising and passing away called momentary rising and passing away. If you pay attention to the causes, as soon as they rise, they pass away very, very quickly. So this is called momentary rising and passing away. In the same way, if you pay attention to ultimate mentality and materiality, you will see that they, as soon as they rise, they pass away very, very quickly. So this is also called momentary rising and passing away. So in this case, you should try to understand both causal rising and passing away and momentary rising and passing away. Pichya do udiyabhya dasana and khana do udiyabhya dasana. How you should try? There are different way of teaching to understand this dependent origination. Among these different types of ways, I want to introduce you according to Pichya Sutta of Nidana Vaga Sanyutta Bali. Pichya Sutta. In Pichya Sutta, Buddha explains dependent, how do you should try to understand dependent origination from the middle to the beginning. But if you want to practice dependent origination first, you should try to learn by heart the formula of dependent origination. What is the formula of dependent origination? Avijja vijja sankhara, sankhara vijja avijjana, avijjana vijja nama rupa, nama rupa vijja salayarana, salayarana vijja phasa, phasa vijja virana, virana vijja dana, dana vijja upadana, upadana vijja bhava, bhava vijja jadi, jadi vijja jaramrana, soga brideva, dukha dhavana, subhayasa sambhondi. Iwa medasa kevala sa dukkha khandasa samudayo hoti. This is formula. When you are discerning this formula, with the rising of ignorance, sankhara formation, volitional formations arise, comes to be. With the rising of volitional formations, consciousness, vijnana, comes to be, etc. In this way, causal relationship you must try to understand. But what is avijja, ignorance, what is sankhara, formations, when they had been raised? So you should try to understand this clearly. How you should try to understand? Buddha, in Pichya Sutta, Buddha taught to discern from the middle to the end, to the beginning. Avijja, ignorance. Middle means in the now you are accumulating wholesome and unwholesome dhammas in this very life. Among these wholesome and unwholesome dhammas, sometimes you may wish to become in future man or woman or deva. What do you want to be in future? What is your wish? This is, if you understand in, at the present dependent origination, then you will also understand the dependent origination of the past. For example, when you are doing donation to the Buddha, some flowers, for example, if please wish to be God, a bhikkhu in future life. Maybe whether do you want or not, I don't know. For example only. When you are offering flower to the Buddha image, if you wish to become a bhikkhu in future life, who can meditate thoroughly to attain nibbana, for example. Then, in this case, if you understand as a bhikkhu, That understanding is wrong understanding. Why? If you get some four elements systematically in that bhikkhu's body, you cannot see bhikkhu, you can see only just a group of small bodyguards called kalabas. If you analyze this kalabas, you can see only ultimate materiality. Then if you can continue to discern ultimate mentality, then you can also understand ultimate mentality. So there is nothing bhikkhu, only ultimate materiality and mentality. If you understand there are only ultimate materiality and mentality, this understanding is called right view samadhi. But if you understand as a bhikkhu, such type of understanding is called wrong understanding. That wrong understanding is called ignorance avijja. So depending on avijja, you may have attachment to the bhikkhu life in future existence. That attachment is called tanha craving. Repeated craving is called clinging upadana. So altogether there are three defilements: avijja, ignorance, tanha, craving, upadana, clinging. Depending on these defilements, you accumulate volitional formations, sankhara. What type of sankhara? You offer flower to the Buddha image. While you are offering flowers to the Buddha image, if you offer with happy mind and with understanding knowledge about the activity of the law of karma, then there are 34 mental formations which are mentioned in Pajana in my last Dhamma talk. So these 34 mental formations are called sankhara. Why they are called sankhara? They can produce to future five aggregates called bhikkhu life. So they are called sankhara. But this sankhara is volitional formations. These volitional formations are nature impermanent. As soon as they arise, they pass away very, very quickly. So they are nature impermanent. But when they pass away, they left behind the energy or potentiality to produce five aggregates called bhikkhu. Such potentiality is called karma. Altogether, there are five causes. Number one, avijja, ignorance. Number two, tanha, craving. Number three, upadana, clinging. Number four, sankhara, volitional formations. Number five, karma. Altogether, there are five causes. So you should notice these five causes while really you are offering flower to the Buddha. And then please go to your meditation hall. And then please re-establish your anabana jhana, up to fourth jhana. Please re-establish your jhana concentration. When strong, powerful light appear, please try four elements meditation systematically and please discern ultimate materiality and mentality, internally and externally both. After that, you should discern ultimate mentality bhagwa when you are really offering flowers to the Buddha image. So ultimate mentality, materiality, in Pali it is called nama rupa. Mentality is nama, rupa is materiality. You should discern this nama rupa bhagwa. Slowly nama rupa. As if while you are discerning external world, Then if you discern in this way, while you are really offering flowers to the Buddha image, at that time you may be able to discern ultimate mentality and materiality, nama and rupa. You should check whether these nama rupas are real nama rupa, when I'm offering flowers to the Buddha image. Then if you understand they are same nama rupa, then it is sure you can discern proximate past nama rupa, we can say. We can say you can discern proximate past nama rupa. After discerning nama rupa in this way, slowly discern nama rupa Bhagava Abdu, Mother's womb. Inside mother's womb, there is also nama rupa. Slowly, please discern nama rupa up to the beginning stage of conception. At the beginning stage of conception, there are also nama rupa, mentality and materiality. At the beginning stage, there are three types of kalabas: body jagat kalaba, sex jagat kalaba, and heart jagat kalaba, three types of kalabas. If you analyze these kalabas, in each kalaba there are 10 types of materiality, so there are altogether 30 types of materiality. And then please discern mentality in the conception stage, but lingering mind moment. You can see there were 34 mental formations or 33 mental formations. If you are body sadhi, but lingering mind moment is associated with PD and wisdom faculty, there are 34 mental formations. But sometimes for some meditators, there may be no PD join. So there may be only 33. So if you can discern this mentality and materiality, then you should trace Bhagava, nama rupa. In previous slide, there is that mind moment. At that mind moment also, you should try to discern nama rupa. Then forward, please discern nama rupa. Then near death moment, there are also nama rupa. We call maranasana javana, death proximate javana mind moment. When you are discerning death proximate javana mind moment, at that time you may see the object of those javanas. Javana is called impulsion, they translate as impulsion. Last cognitive process before death mind moment, before death consciousness appear. The last cognitive process is called Maranasana Javana mind moment. Death proximate mind moment. If you can discern the impulses, then you should also try to discern the object of those impulses. There may be one of the object, karma, or karma, the sign of karma or destination. So I want to explain with one example. A meditator, while she is discerning these causes, dependent origination, before that moment, she saw only reddish color only, just for only few seconds. But 1 second, within 1 second or 2 seconds, she can see only reddish color, red color only. Then I told her to discern forward. Then forward, if she discern nama rupa forward, then she saw one sign of karma. What is karma? Sign of karma. Before that moment, one object appear, one chediya. Chediya, do you understand chediya? Chediya is, they translate pagoda or maybe temple. One chediya like Shurigong pagoda. Then she saw that chediya. And then nearby, she was teaching young sisters, young nuns. The Buddha Dhamma, the Dhamma of Buddha, the teaching of Buddha. And then again, she also saw some cruel, she offered to the Buddha. So there are three signs. Number one is reddish color. Number two is jidya. Number three is offerings. And then teaching the Dhamma to the young nuns. So when she is teaching the young nuns, the teaching of the Buddha, this is also called, she was accumulating wholesome dhammas. When she is offering gruel to the Buddha, at that time also she is accumulating wholesome dhammas. So there are two types of wholesome dhammas. Which wholesome dhamma produce in this very life? Five aggregates. If she investigates again and again, she saw that when she is offering gruel to the Buddha, such wholesome dhammas produce five aggregates of in this present life. So what is her wish? She again investigates this wish. When she is investigating this wish, she saw that she wished to be a lady, to become a lady who can serve Bhikkhu Sangha properly. So if she understands as a lady who can serve Sangha properly, such type of understanding is called ignorance, because there is no lady, only ultimate materiality and mentality. But if she understands as a lady who can serve Sangha properly, such understanding is called wrong understanding. That wrong understanding is called ignorance. Then she have attachment to that lady life. This is called tanha craving. Repeated attachment to that lady life is called upadana kalinga. So three defilement rounds. Depending on these three defilement rounds, she accumulate wholesome dhammas. She offered gruel to the Buddha. This is sankhara formations. But these sankhara formations are also nature impermanent. As soon as they rise, they pass away very, very quickly. But they left behind the karma energy or karma potentiality to produce this result according to her own wish. So that karma potentiality is karma. Altogether, there are five causes: avijja, ignorance, tanha, craving, upadana, clinging, sankhara, volitional formations, and karma. Altogether, there are five causes. Among these five causes, karma is very important. If she can discern the karma, then she should try to discern one side karma, then another side. In this very life, mentality, materiality, and the in time of conception stage, but linking mind movement. Among this mentality, materiality, for clear understanding, she should emphasize only materiality, rupa. So in past life, there is karma. In present life, conception, at the stage of conception stage, rupa. So karma, rupa, again, if she descends, then she will see this karma produce this materiality, other than she understood. Other than only, this is the beginning stage of understanding of dependent origination only. But what is the red color? The red color is destination. What is the destination for human beings? For human beings, the destination is mother's womb only. That mother's womb color is reddish color, red color. That red color is last sign. We call this is the sign of destination. Gati nimitta. That gati nimitta appear because of the previous karma only. So previous karma is which karma? Offering growth to the Buddha. What is her own wish? Her wish is to become a lady who can serve Sangha properly. So because of this avijja, ignorance, tanha, craving, upadana, clinging, sankhara, volitional formations, and karma, then five aggregates in terms of conception arise. She understands clearly. In the same way, she should try to discern cause and effect along the like five aggregates in the same way. But this is only one example. But there are also some examples, many interesting examples. Today also, one doctor asked me about this question. There is one bhikkhu. In his proximate past life, he began a cult. But one karma produced which he had accumulated in his second past life. That karma produced five aggregates in this life. What is the problem? The problem is, in second past life, he was a bhikkhu. As a bhikkhu, he practiced samatha vipassana as far as he can. But at that time, he was vegetarian. But others also eat beef. He criticized too much. Why you should eat as a bhikkhu? Others beef, animals beef. He criticized too much. While he is criticizing too much to others, at that time he had accumulated many unwholesome dhammas. These unwholesome dhammas are dosa group, inga group. He don't like others who eat beef. That criticism very dangerous. Before that moment, this criticism appear again, that anger appear again. Because of this anger, volitional formation, sankhara, anger, sankhara, he began kong. Why? Depending on kong, he criticized others, especially beef. So, because of this reason, this criticism, he began kong in past life. But when he began gone, he remembered his past bhikkhu's life. Although he began bhikkhu, he began gone, he began unhappy. Frequently, tears are always coming up from his eyes. But one day, gone also passed away. Near that moment, he saw good signs. What are good signs? Second past life, as a bhikkhu, he practiced four elements meditation systematically. He can see adimic materiality only, but he cannot see adimic mentality. He can see adimic materiality partially only, not fully. He can discern four elements meditation systematically, and he can see kalabas. In each kalabas, partially, he can discern four elements only. This is his wholesome karma. So because of this karma, become mature in the time of death, in past life. This karma produced in this present life five aggregates again. So sometimes karmas are in past life, but some karmas are in second past life, or maybe more than second past life, etc. So when you are descending independent origination, you should carefully try to understand these examples. In the same way, there is also one lady. When she is descending dependent origination, near that moment in time of previous past life, she can see only white color only. She cannot see nothing. Maybe one day, 2 days, she cannot penetrate this white. What is white color? She did not understand. Then I suggest her to go through beyond this white color. Then slowly she saw white color. White color is in second past life only, not in first past life. What is the reason? I will explain later. Then if she go through this white color, she saw one lady. That lady is offering papaya fruit to a bhikkhu who is going for alms round in the village. At that time, she is very poor. Because of this reason, she cannot learn her grant, her education. She cannot accumulate her education. Because of this reason, she wished to become a lady in big city, as well as to become an educated woman. This is her wish. So if she understands as educated woman, such type of understanding is wrong understanding, called ignorance. Depending on ignorance, she had attachment to the educated woman life. This is called craving, tana craving. Repeated craving is called clinging. Based on these three defilements, she accumulate wholesome tamas. What type of wholesome tamas? She offer one fruit to the bhikkhu who is going for alms round. When she is offering this fruit to the bhikkhu, at that day, we can say she was accumulated wholesome tamas. There are 24 mandala formations, same as mentioned in Pajana. These 34 mental formations are also nature impermanent. As soon as they arise, they pass away very, very quickly. But they left behind karma force or karma potentiality, karma energy. That karma potentiality is called karma. Altogether, there are 5 causes: avijja, ignorance, tanha, craving, upadana, clinging, Sankhara, volitional formations, and karma, altogether 5 causes. This karma produces in this very life, 5 aggregates in the end of conception moment. But what is white color? If she descends nama, rupa, mentality, mriyadi in second, first past life, up to the second past life, and then she understood. She understood well. In second past life, she was a lady, but at that time she is Christian, not Buddhist. She offered a school, what called primary school, building, in a village. When they are doing opening ceremony, on that day, they put ceilings above. White cloth, and they surrounding also everywhere white cloth. This is when they are trying opening ceremony and donation day. These objects appear in time of death. When she was near that moment, this white gala object appear in her mind. Taking this white gala as object, she passed away. And then she was reborn as a poor lady in one village because of this wholesome karma. But that white gala is near, in first place, like near that moment. What is the when they are appear, because the object of that proximate invasion jhana is white color and second first light. We call this is the object of Maranasana Javana, that proximate invulsion mind movement. In her first past life, Padisandi consciousness, but lingering mind movement, and Bhuenga consciousness, life continuing consciousness, and death consciousness. These three also take this same color, white color object. This is sign of karma only, karma niveda. So, in first past life, when she is near death moment, she became unconscious for many days. When she became unconscious, at that time, Bhuenga mind stays successfully rising and passing away for many times, for 2 or 3 days maybe. That Bhuenga mind stays object is that white color. So, because of this reason, when she is descending, Namarupa in past past life, she cannot penetrate this white color for many days. So please go through in this way and suggest other than only she can see, she can saw the one poor lady offering one fruit to a bhikkhu who was going arms around in the village. So other than only she saw this image. So for those who are unconscious near that moment, that Bhuenga mind states objects are successively rising and passing away for many times. Some persons may become unconscious 2 or 3 days, etc. Other than this example is very useful. But when you are practicing dependent origination, you should not also try only rising states, causal arising, but you should also try to understand causal cessation, because Buddha also instruct to discern causal arising in Mahasri Brahma Sutta, Vaya Dhamma Nubhasiva Kaya Samay Viharadi, etc. How you should try, I will explain tomorrow. Today I will stop here. Okay, any question you can try.
Medical journals reported that a heart transplant patient after recovery shows personality and habits of the donor. For example, a woman received a heart from a young man. She has a personality change and likes loud music and junk food afterwards. How could this transfer of nama-rupa or consciousness be explained? Does the heart base carry the donor's old habits and some memory?
So this problem is very difficult to explain. According to Buddha's teaching, heart base is the inside the blood only. That blood go through the heart. Inside the heart there is blood, small quantity of blood. If you can take some poor animals in that blood, you can see only blood is nothing but a group of small particles called kalabas only. These kalabas, if you analyze, there are six types of kalaba. Among six types, one type of kalaba is called hardage kalaba. That hardage kalaba, if you analyze, there are 10 types of materiality, such as earth element, water element, fire element, wind element, color, odor, flavor, nutritive essence, life faculty, and heart base. Altogether, there are 10 types. Many mind consciousness, mano dhatu and mano vinyana dhatu. Mind consciousness arises depending on this heart base, but eye consciousness arises depending on eye base, eye sensitivity, ear sensitivity, etc. So mind consciousness arises depending on heart base. But when they are transferring, transplant. Do you understand JD and JD? Maybe you may see some pagodas in our country, for example, Shurigun Pagoda, etc. This is only the house of Buddha's relics only, not Chidiya. Inside the pagoda, there is some relics such as Buddha's head hair, Buddha's body relics, etc. They are Chidiya. So the Chidiya in the house of Chidiya, you should try to distinguish. In the same way, here heart. Heart is only the house of blood only. Blood go through the heart only. But that blood is going through all the body according to conventional truth. According to ultimate sense, they never change from one place to another. As soon as they rise, they pass away very, very quickly. But when the blood is inside the heart, at that time only heart-dage kalaba arise, heart base arise. When they are transplant the heart, at that time blood is still there. No blood is outside. But maybe they may put somewhere, but inside blood there is heart place because of previous karma. If karma is finished, although they may transplant, but they cannot be alive because karma is finished. But as long as there is karma which can produce heart pains, then he or she will not die. But the mind change is very, very difficult to explain. Because of, according to Buddha's teaching, because of previous karma only. Not because of the heart base changing. Because of the heart. Because of previous karma. In previous karma, when they are accumulating wholesome or unwholesome dhammas, their mind is maybe shaking. Sometimes they may want to become men, sometimes they may want to become women, etc. So because of this vijja, tanha, upadana, ignorance, craving, and clinging, their five aggregates also a little bit changing only. Because of karma only, not because of the transplant of the heart base.
Please explain when you see jhana factors of the first jhana, and then when you go to the second jhana, how can you practically differentiate the two? Please explain what we see and how we feel as a beginner to understand the words vitaka vicharya. What is the fifth jhana, and what kind of people have to attain that? People who have less wisdom?
Please bring this pradigali. It is better. If you bring this pradigali, you will understand more clearly. So, if you want to go to from first jhana to second jhana, you should re-establish your first jhana repeatedly for many times. It is better. In ancient time, many Mahatheras, they practice Pajana for many months because they want to make sure only, to make stable. So, if you want to go to second jhana, please re-establish your Pajana for 1 hour. As soon as you emerge from your Pajana, you should reflect. This Pajana is close to the enemy hindrances. This is one disadvantage. Another is, please reflect jhana padas, vijaga vichara, initial obligation of the mind to the anabana bribhaga nimeda, etc. Sustained obligation of the mind to the anabana bribhaga nimeda, etc. This initial obligation and sustained obligation is very cross, because you want very peaceful concentration. You must apply again and again. That obligation is a gross manner of mind. Applying your mind to the object again and again is gross manner of mind. Without obligation, mind stay with your jhana object. It is very good. So this is gross manner. Because of this grossness, the jhana can easily fall down. So, this is the disadvantage of Pajana. Then please reflect Piti Sukha Igagada. This is the Moha Kwaya. This is the Jhana Fetas of Second Jhana. After reflecting in this way, with the intention to attain Second Jhana, you should focus on your Anapana Pribhaga Nimitta again. When you are focusing on your Anapana Pribhaga Nimitta again, then very soon full absorption may arise. But for some meditators who repeatedly practice second jhana again and again, they can directly go to second jhana for its parts. But for beginners, they may go back to the first jhana again. That full absorption may be first jhana. But they should stay in first jhana for 10 minutes or more than 10 minutes. Imagine from first jhana, as soon as they emerge from Pajana, they should reflect jhana padas. When reflecting jhana padas, at that time they will see Buddhaga Vichara is very gross. Initial obligation of the mind and sustained obligation of the mind to the Anapana Pribhaga Nimitta is very gross. Piti Sukha Igagada, joy, happiness and one-pointedness, these three jhana padas are very peaceful. And then with the intention to remove gross fetters and to attain subtle, peaceful fetters, which are the jhana fetters of second jhana, then you should focus on your anapana pribhaga nimitta again. When concentrating on your anapana pribhaga nimitta again, then full absorption will appear. That full absorption, usually many meditators report me, they say that very more peaceful than Pajana. They will understand because two jhana fetters are absent. Only three jhana fetters, joy, happiness, one-pointedness. These three are present only. But for many meditators, when they are focusing on the anapana pribhaga nimitta, full absorption may arise, this second jhana full absorption. But that full absorption for beginners only one mind moment. At that mind moment, they penetrate anapana pribhaga nimitta only. But they quickly emerge from jhana, and when they are, at that time, they will be vidaga vichara, initial obligation and sustained obligation disappear. And then piti sukha ikagata, joy, happiness, and one-pointedness, three only remain. They will see. But they should not emphasize the jhana fetters. They should emphasize anapana pribhaga nimitta only. When they are concentrating anapana pribhaga nimitta, very quickly they will end up into second jhana again. And then they can maintain the second jhana for a long time. If they can maintain this second jhana for a long time, when emerge from the second jhana, when they are reflecting jhana filters, they will see Buddhaga Vichara Disviya. Only Piti Sukha Igagata, three jhana filters are present. If they practice practically, they may understand five jhana and second jhana. Then what is the fifth jhana? What kind of people have to attain that? People who have keen wisdom, not keen wisdom. Usually Buddha teach fifth method for dull wisdom. For those who have dull wisdom. Dull wisdom is not too dull. According to Baliwa only they are translated. They are also sharp wisdom, but not sharp like pastime. Pastime means there are two types of rupa jhanas. One is five jhana, second jhana, third jhana, fourth jhana. This is one type. Another type is five jhana, second jhana, third jhana, fourth jhana, fifth jhana. This is another type. That second type Buddha taught for dull persons. But really they are not too dull. If we compare with first person only, they are a little bit dull only. What is the reason? Some meditators, when they are removing jhana fetters, some persons who have sharp wisdom, keen wisdom, they can remove Buddhaga and Vichara simultaneously together. But some meditators, they cannot remove Buddhaga and Vichara together. So they must remove Buddhaga first time. If they remove Buddhaga, then they will remain four jhana fetters. And then second time, they must remove Vichara. At that time, three jhana fetters will remain. So they practice separately in this way only. Then third jhana, in the fifth method, second jhana began third jhana. Third jhana began fourth jhana, fourth jhana began fifth jhana only. Okay. Today, let us stop here. Okay. Oh, sorry, sharing with it. Idhami punya asavakhaya vaha hodu. Idhami punya nibbanasa pachaya hodu. Idhami punya sabha sadhana bhajima kesabhi mesama punya bhaga labhantu sadhu sadhu sadhu.